lose myself deep in your eyes. And all at once I'm found in.
Hey guys, my name is Jordy for Cinecom.net, and you're watching Copycat Friday, where we recreate a cool effect from a creator, a music video, or a film. And today we are having a look at this effect right here from Ariana Grande. The light is coming! Ariana Grande came out with a brand new music video that plays back in a forest. And at a certain moment, you would see these multiple poses of her, which is kind of a future trail of her movement. Pretty cool, and that is what we're going to recreate today in this video. But first, a big shout out to Storyblocks, which is a growing library of stock footage, video effects, animations, templates, and so much more. We've been using it for almost 2 years, and having always access to so many video assets has helped us on a ton of projects. And the cool thing is that you only have to pay one price per year, which allows you to download unlimited files. For more information, click the first link in the description below.
Give me love, now unconditional.
This right here is the Spekular Lights, guys. It comes with these building blocks and you can create your own shapes. Pretty cool. The clip of Ariana Grande plays in a forest. We are going to recreate that in the studio, so that's why we got ourselves some plants.
Afraid I'll lose myself deep in your eyes. And all at once I'm found and recognized. Uh-oh, you caught me, honey, unbelievable.
As you guys know, Kim, my girlfriend, she's a speech-language pathologist and she sees a lot of children, and those children can make a drawing for her, and she uses this board tree thing to hang up those drawings. But I stole it!
All the emotions flood like the ocean. Oh, ow.
Oh, wrong camera. So once everything was set up, we could start shooting. We filmed everything from a tripod, as that is the easiest way to pull off the effects. But let's first start off with the basics. You want to have yourself running around or dancing in a static shot, and that's it. Then open up Premiere Pro and bring the shot into your timeline. Look for the first point where you jump in the air or take up a nice pose. Duplicate layer here to the track above. Trim it on the right side to your playhead. Right-click on the clip and choose Frame Hold. With the clip selected, head over to the Opacity Properties and choose the Pen tool to draw a mask. You want to do this around yourself and you want to make sure that you do this precise. It takes up a little time, but the end result is pretty cool. And once you're done, just play your video and the effect should already work. You can continue now to make more of these duplications at further time points. Trim, frame hold, mask, and that's it. Now, in the music video, you would also see these echo effects as she comes through one of her poses. In Premiere Pro, there is actually an echo effect, but using this didn't turn out the way that we hoped for. So we're going to do it a little bit different. Select everything in your timeline, right-click, and choose Nest. This will group everything together in one nested sequence. Duplicate this layer 3 times. Now, select your first duplication and nudge it 2 frames to the right. Do the same thing with the layer above, but then nudge it 4 times. And the last one goes 6 frames to the right. Next, change the opacity of the first duplication to 40, the second duplication to 30, and the last one to 20. Add a cut to all of your duplications when you're jumping into your pose. Go a little bit further and add another cut. Do this for every pose that you've created prior. And once you're done, add a cross dissolve to all of those duplications to let them fade in and out. Now, since these ghosts are laying on top, it will cover your subject too much. And that's why I'm going to create a rough mask on the first duplication around the back of myself. And this can be pretty rough, and you want to feather the mask as well. Enable animation for the mask path and move the mask a little bit with the movement. Now, this mask has to be the same for all of the duplications, so copy the one that you just created and paste it to the others. The ghosts look a little bit too sharp, which is why I'm going to add a Gaussian blur to each duplication as a final touch. And that already gives you the proper ghosting effect, but we can take it even a step further and add a little RGB glitch effect into it. Select everything in your timeline and nest it again. Duplicate that nested sequence again 3 times and nudge each duplication like we've done before. This time you can offset the first one for 1 frame, the next 2 frames, and the last one 3 frames. Get around the ghosting effect for all of the layers. The tree on top can be trimmed to only cover the effect. The layer on the bottom, which you've cut around, can be removed. What we're now going to do is extract the channels red, green, and blue from each layer. We can do this with the color balance effect. For the first layer, I'm going to set red and green to 0 and blue to maximum. For the next duplicate, I set blue and red to 0 and green to maximum. And finally, the last one, I set red to maximum and the rest to 0. We've now extracted the channels, but we want to blend them back together as we only want to see small areas of this glitch. And that is why I'm setting the blend mode of all these duplications to screen. Pretty cool now is that you won't see these separate channels as long as all the clips are equal. Once there's an offset, like if you would change the position of one of these clips, those channels will reveal itself. And because we've nudged the clips by a couple of frames in the beginning, the movement has an offset which adds that RGB glitch in there. Since it was furthermore shot on a tripod, the background doesn't change and thus you only see the glitch on your subjects. Since it was all shot from a tripod, you could add a fake camera motion to it by animating the position and scale or adding one of our free handheld presets to it. And that was it again. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you, Videoblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
How they do it at the club right now.
No, Lorenzo, that's not how they do it at the club right now.
This is how they do it at the club.